Welcome to part one of A Beautiful Game. This is the Karma rendering series, and in the series, we're going to be going through everything Karma related. So as of the release of Houdini 19, Karma is now ready for production, right? So it's been in beta, but now it is in final release. As such, some things have changed, some things have been added, there's new functionality, and now would be a good time to figure out the transition from Mantra to Karma. Additionally, with Karma XPU now being in alpha, we can expect further releases of XPU in the future, so I do believe it would be beneficial to learn Karma in the interim. Now, this series is broken up into multiple parts. Part 1 is just an overview. So this part is just explaining how this series is structured and how you can make the most of it. To follow along with the rest of the series, you will be needing the files that we have provided. So because this is a rendering series, we don't want to have to focus on creating assets and all of that. So we've created a set of assets for you. We've created a chessboard, all with material X shaders assigned to all pieces, and they're set up in various scenes. So in the description below, you will find a link to two sets of files. You will find one that has the cache, which is about 3 GB, and one that has no cache. The reason I've included one with no cache is just that if you don't want to download the entire 3 GB cache for whatever reason, perhaps you don't have disk space or you're on a limited network, then go ahead and download the one without the cache. You'll be able to follow along perfectly fine until part 7. From part 7, we'll be focusing on some volumes, and that's where you're going to be needing the cache. So if you'd like, you can download that. Now the series stands as individual parts. You don't have to watch every part. You can just watch whatever piece you need for whatever situation you're currently in. For example, if you need to know how to set up Material X and Vex Base Shaders, you can go ahead and look at part 4. So let me go through each of the parts and tell you what is in each one. Part 1, this is the overview, the introduction. Part 2, we finally get into some of the changes to Karma, what's been introduced in 19, where Karma currently stands, and how to transition from Mantra to Karma. So part 2 will briefly explore how Karma can be used instead of Mantra without much of a change to the workflow of rendering in Houdini. Part 3 is the Karma ROP and Karma XPU. So in part 3 we're going to be looking at the Karma ROP, which allows you to work at the SOP level and then render out as you usually would. You don't have to go to the LOP level, and so we're going to be going through all of that in part 3. We're also going to be looking at where XPU currently stands, some of its limitations, and how you can currently use it. In part 4, we're going to be going over Material X and Vex-based shading. So Material X being the new introduction to Karma, which allows for materials that can be used in various render engines. In part 5, we're going over Solaris scene setup and lighting. So we're going to be setting up lights and cameras in Solaris, how you can use the various lights, as well as going over the new IES functionality for spotlights. We're also going to be using the light mixer, and finally we'll look at the snapshot feature. In part 6, we're going to be looking at Karma render settings. So this is the Karma output node at the Solaris level. We'll be looking at sampling, convergence modes, denoising, limits, depth of field, and a couple of other miscellaneous things. There is some useful information on depth of field in that part, so if you're looking for depth of field, it is included in part 6. Part 7 is where we will start using volumes, and we're going to be looking at motion blur, velocity blur, and volume blur. How do you use an attribute to drive velocity blur in Solaris? How do you use a VDB velocity grid to drive volume motion blur? And how do you use motion blur when you don't have any attributes? So that's what part 7 is all about. Part 8, we're looking at Material X and shaped volumes with Karma and Solaris. So we're going to be creating a Vex Base shader and a Material X shader for volumes. And we'll also be looking at how to create a new shaped volume, so one that fits to the camera thruster. That is another thing that has been introduced in 19. In part 9, we're looking at Karma AOVs and light path expressions, also known as LPEs. This is where we'll be looking at how to reconstruct a beauty pass, how to get things like Z-depth, cryptomats, diffuse, specular, all of your different passes, as well as how to split them per light so that you can individually control each light's intensity and color and contribution to the scene in post. In part 10, we're going to be looking at advanced settings. This will include things like deep camera maps, overscan, cropping, and we're going to be addressing some bugs and common issues that you may come across. That will be the final part, and then the series will come to a close. So let's go ahead and start using these tutorials. If you want to play around with the files that are included down below, feel free. They are now publicly available, If you make any sort of cool renders or anything using Karma and Solaris, I'm sure SideFX would love to see those types of things, so be sure to tag them on Instagram at SideFXHoudini. And if you want to show me what you did with these files as well, you can tag me at 9_between. So let's get into this tutorial series. Go ahead and download the files, and I will see you in part 2.